Respected Chairman Sri M. Lakshman Reddy sir, respected Executive Director Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav sir, and the Director of St. Martin Engineering College Sri Jai Kishan Yadav sir, other management members in absentia, and guest of today's day, friend of Chairman sir on stage, and Deans, HODs, last but not the least, the staff member of St. Martin Engineering College. A very good afternoon to all of you, and I wish you all a very happy Teachers' Day. So, in fact, it was a very delighted moment for all the teachers, because yearly once the Teachers' Day is celebrated, and already before me, Dr. Hemamika Madam already informed to all of you that why the Teachers' Day is celebrated, and being a teacher, it is all known to us. And because as you know, Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, his birthday was on 5th September 1888. So, and he was a big role model for the student. And we can say that he was everything for the student. So, student, they used to believe him, they used to like him, and they used to follow him in all 360 degree angles. So, when his birthday was there, so a group of students, they decided to go and celebrate his birthday. And they reached to Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. And Dr. Radhakrishnan, see, such a humble and a great personality, he told, no need to celebrate my birthday. In case you wanted to celebrate, treat it as a teacher's day and start celebrating. So the gratitude and the respect should be given to all teachers in case you wanted to celebrate my birthday. So, from henceforth onwards, the Teacher's Day is celebrated on his birthday. So, he has come from a very humble background, and there is a place called Tiruthani. Who are all from Tamil Nadu, they might be aware. There is a place called Tiruthani in Tamil Nadu. So, he was born from that place, and he was there, and he came, and he started his career as an academician, and followed with all different positions, and finally, he landed as a Vice Chancellor of Andhra University. So he worked for 5 years as a Vice Chancellor of Andhra University, and after that he has been invited to act as a Vice Chancellor for those days the India's biggest university is Banaras Hindu University. Even I think today also if you will see and take the data, I think Banaras Hindu University might be the biggest university in India. So then he was invited to act as a Vice Chancellor for that university too. So again he worked as a Vice Chancellor for that university for 5 years. He had never applied for the Vice Chancellor post. He had been invited. So followed with, see the power of a teacher. Why I am reiterating his biography, the power of teacher, how it is. He was invited and he acted as a Vice Chancellor. After this Vice Chancellor tenure was over, he was not a politician also, but because of his humbleness, good character, and the power of educating to the youth, it took him to the very next level, and he has been offered as a Vice President of India when the presidency of Rajendra Prasad sir was going on. So he was invited and he was given. Even he was not belongs to Congress party, he was not belongs to any political parties, but he has been offered. So he was the first Vice President, followed with the second President of India. So that tenure also he completed successfully. And there are some interesting facts about him. I think few of you might be knowing, or maybe some of you might be knowing of it. During the tenure of Vice President and the Presidentship, so the Government of India has a provision of giving the salary to those people also. So whatever all his expenditure he has calculated, whatever all his expenditures are required, that is the only amount he used to retain with him. The remaining entire salary and whatever the party fund or whatever the amount he used to get it, he used to donate it to the Prime Minister Relief Fund. He has not carried a single rupee to his home. That is the duty of the teacher. So, as Dr. Hemamika was already telling to you that he has written a lot of books. So, but there are two books which, very close to my heart and mind. And I request all of you, if you get time, so please get those books. And if you read, it will change, it will transfer the personality and it will take you to the very next level. So, one book I could able to remember, Idealistic View of Life. So, the beauty of that book, he has compared the different ideology of different personality and how the present generation should be, which he could able to anticipate what is happening now, he could able to anticipate before 100 years itself. That is what it is written in a very beautiful way. And another one is The Ethics of Bhagavad Gita, he has written. So see, he was born in a Brahmin family, purely a Hindu boy, Brahmin family, born and brought up. But he had completed all of his education from the Christian minority school. So that is why he was having good knowledge not only on Bhagavad Gita, even other religions too. And everywhere he used to tell, okay, the humanity is the greatest thing what every religion will teach to you. And he believed on that and he lived his life with that philosophy. So we are very proud for such a great personality what we had for India. And today we are very proud that we are in this profession and we are celebrating his birthday as a Teacher's Day. Similarly, there are n number of teachers, not only in India, across the globe, we can start giving the example and their remarkable achievements and the contribution for the society and the community. So time will not be enough. But here in this junction, again, I would like to recall one of the great personality. He was also our former president of India, Sri Dr. Abdul Kalam sir. So Dr. Abdul Kalam sir used to tell to every individual, whoever the student or whoever any public forum he gets an opportunity to address someone, he used to tell, the great culture and the great human being will come from three people. And these three people are, one is father, another one is mother, and the third one is from the teacher. So that is why he was having very high regards towards the teacher, and he used to say that this is one of the best noble profession in the world, and education is the only tool which has got the potentiality to change the nation. That is what Abdul Kalam sir used to say. So I used to remember him in every Teacher's Day. In fact, because the belongingness, the gratitude what he had shown to all the teachers. And finally, one more character it comes to my mind, quite interesting and different also. But I used to appreciate his leadership and the teaching skill, the Acharya Chanakya. So I think Chanakya name everybody would have heard. See how his interesting character is. So after completion of all his educations and all, he started working as a professor at Nalanda University. Nalanda University, he started teaching to the student and all. And those days what happened? So there was a person called Sikandar. And the Sikandar used to attack to India again and again. And he was disappointed with those kind of activities and the indisciplines, whatever all happening. So being a teacher, see, he could have gone to his university, take the class, would have come back. But he did not sit quiet. He decided it should not happen for India and India needs a great king. So he decided to search a king and put him for India so that this kind of Sikandar and in henceforth also who are all culprits are there, they should not be attacking to our India. Then he started mingling with different kings, and when in this junction he met with a king of Magadha, and that king name is Dhananand. So this Dhananand character is quite interesting. You know that he wanted to live a very lavish life. He doesn't want to care anyone and all, even though he was having a very big battalion with him. So he doesn't want to care. So when this Chanakya wanted to talk to him and wanted to inform him that this is what it is going to happen and we are going to lose our country, he did not believe him. In return, he has given a kick to him and he has thrown him out from his kingdom. So now you see the teacher, when he went in a very polite way and represented to the king, how his anger he changed into a resolution. And what kind of resolution he brought it to his mind? Okay, I will build the king for India. And he got hold of a 12 years old boy named as Chandu, and later on the character Chandragupta, and groomed him, dedicated his entire life to groom him and to make him as a king of India. And finally the story, the battle had happened and Chandragupta won. And finally that is what the teachers And being a, you know, Chanakya's biography, if you will read, nowadays we talk about foreign ministry, we talk about the education minister, we talk about the home minister. All these ministry capabilities and the talents, as a single person he was having. And before I conclude, I wanted to tell to you one small incident with, about Chanakya. That is why I used to call him really a very great teacher. Okay, so even though he was having so much of intelligence and knowledge, and he knows how to deal with the people, how to control the team, he could be the king. But he doesn't want to take that post. He wanted to train someone and keep him as a king because he believed that he is a teacher. And this thought and this mindset was there from his childhood itself. I will tell you one small incident what the childhood it was. One day what happened, he was just a 8-9 years old boy, Chanakya, and to his home one saint came. The moment the saint entered to his house, came to near, reached to his door, then Chanakya was playing outside. Then Chanakya's mother, by seeing the saint, was very happy, and he had taken the astrology of Chanakya and given to that saint and asked, because you are all saints, because traditional days we know, right? The saints means they are the, by default they are the astrologers. So he started asking about the future prediction of Chanakya. Interestingly, this saint, he told one thing, that even though he has born in a very humble family and all, his future is, he is going to rule the country. What he told? He is going to rule the country. He is going to be a great administrator in future. By hearing this message, because they are from very small and simple family, mother felt very much disappointed and started crying. And why she started crying? She felt that, you know, she want always her son should be beside him, but if he is going to be administrator, definitely he has to leave this village, he has to leave this home, and he has to go. For which the mother was not ready. And by the time the Chanakya entered, see, the mind of an 8-9 years old boy entered and asked, okay, so what happened, mother? Why are you crying? Then mother told that one, no, the saint had come and the saint had told like this. No, how to believe that one? Then the mother told, the saint had told one more reason also, because I also asked the same question. The saint told that if you want to check whether my statement is correct or not, ask your son to open the mouth and see the canine teeth. What is called canine? First teeth are called incisor and the side teeth are called canine teeth. So see the canine teeth, on top of the canine teeth there will be a symbol of a snake. If that is there, he is going to rule. Then mother immediately, out of this curiosity, asked his son to open the mouth and show the canine teeth. Then Chanakya could able to open the mouth and show. And very minutely when it was noticed, there was a symbol of the snake. So mother was again further disappointed and started crying. The moment he saw that mother is crying like this, he picked a stone. By using that stone by his own hand, he started hitting his canine teeth and broke and gave it to his mother. Mother, I am not going to rule anyone, I am not going to lead, I want to be like your son. Why I am narrating this story to you all is, he was not hungry for the power, he was not hungry for the position. He wanted to become a teacher, he wanted to become a mentor, and he lived his life with the legacy of leadership and teacher. So that is why my great respect to all the great teachers in our past days. And also always I believe, okay, so teachers are the backbone of the country, and I really congratulate and appreciate all of you for choosing the teaching as a profession for your life and contributing yourself for the building the nations and for the growth of this country. Once again, congratulations to all of you on this great Teacher's Day, and from my heart I wanted to convey to you for St. Martin Engineering College, because already you all are the stakeholder, you know very well, we togetherly as a team we worked and we got first NAC A+, followed with 2B and 2LF certification from UGC, then again we went for UGC Autonomous, we got the UGC Autonomous for 10 years, then again all the courses, whatever all it is available, we made it as MBA accreditation. And the college is NIRF rank and ATAL rank. And 596 course of funding project, which are all from GHMC and HLWSSB. It has come only to the St. Martin Engineering College. So all this possible because of our team spirit and the hard work and dedication what all of you have shown and contributed. So I salute you for that. And at this junction, before I conclude, I would like to convey my great appreciation to our great leaders of management, because see, the teacher is not like that who comes inside the class and teach. There is an opportunity because life has got different phases. Now in our phase, we will not be sitting inside any classroom and will be learning and making someone as a teacher. So wherever there is an opportunity to groom ourselves, to improve our skill set or to improve our activities. Okay, so that is all we say it as a teacher. So every day with this junction, I would convey all of our gratitude to our beloved chairman sir, Sri M. Lakshman Reddy sir, who used to teach us about the fitness and used to tell to us every day that at least spend half an hour per day, and he doesn't only speak on that, even he does and he believes in that. So it is a great inspiration by seeing you sir all the day, even whenever it is, whether it is raining, whether it is whatever the season it may be. He doesn't care about it, he keeps on doing the same thing, what he used to tell. And the second leader always know, see some people like, whenever we see a movie, okay, we see the characters, right? Okay, hero is there, heroine is there, villain is there. But behind the scene, one more person is there. Who is that? The director. Okay, so our executive director is such a kind of leader, he doesn't want to come upfront on the screen, but all the directions and all the guidance he gives to us. So thank you very much, sir. We learn so many things from you, how to be simple and how to be work motive. And third one, I would like to express my gratitude to our Jai Kishan Yadav sir, who is very young director in our group, and also sir is so dynamic with his dynamic knowledge and the vibration, could able to control 4 schools, and now 5th school is also yet to launch. And sir is also working with one more new project about having a residential college for the student. And in addition to that, sir also takes care and be a part of this St. Martin Engineering College. And whenever he learns something new, he's a very quick learner. Whenever he sees, he try to take out the best from whatever the time he has spent here. So, and I wanted to inculcate all the facilities and all the benefit for the betterment of student and faculty. So, thank you sir for joining us and also making our event memorable. And finally, kudos to all the HODs who are all day and night working with me and doing lot of hard work. And sincerely taking the team completely forward. So once again, happy Teachers Day and have a great evening to all of you. Thank you for the opportunity.